Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Mohammed Adnan and in this video we are going to discuss about the two DAX functions, first non-blank and first non-blank value, and what's the difference between these two. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. The first non-blank. The syntax is the column and then the expression, and the first non-blank value is also the syntax, the same column and expression. The first non-blank returns the first value of the expression filtered by the current context where the expression is not blank. The first non-blank value returns the first non-blank value of the expression corresponding to the sorted value of the column. The example is like this: first non-blank info name and then the true or false, and first non-blank value, the table and column name, comma, the sum of sales. Now let's go into the practical, how it actually works. This is my Power BI file. In this, these are the data. I have this country and then the marketing manager, the salesperson, and how many sales they have made, so forth. So this is the data. And if you want to extract the first value from there, then you can write this DAX function, the first non-blank. The first non-blank column name, comma, the expression, it is true. So it will return the value of the first non-blank in the current filter context. And now if I look at this first non-blank value, it is also the same, the table and column name. And here in the expression, we can write expressions, sum of info sales. By doing that, I am just adding here in a table, the country from this table. And in the first non-blank, I'm just referring it to get the name of the marketing person. So it will return the name of the first marketing person inside that country. So if you look at this here, in India, the first one is Mike, UAE is Bill, and in USA, it is Dan. So it is sorted by alphabetic order. Okay. And if you look at this value here, in the first non-blank value, so I'm just taking the sum of sales here with reference to the name column. This also works in the same way. So it will sort the values in alphabetic order and it will just calculate the sum of sales. In India, the Mike is 45 and Bill is 75 and Dan is 51. Now, one more example is I have removed the country filtration here. That is the filter context. So by doing that, as it sorts by alphabetic order, if you look at these values here, the first name is, if I click on the name column here, the first name which comes here is a Bill. So here it has taken the first non-blank value as a Bill. Instead of in the EL example, we have Mike here because the country is India. And now there is no filter context applied here. So the first name is Bill. It is. And when it comes to the sales, it will also do the same process. It will sort the name by alphabetic order and then it will get the first sales of that person. So it is 75. So Bill is 75. And one more thing, important thing which you have to consider here, it is sorted by alphabetic order. Now let's take an example. If I add one more value to this table, so value has been added here, so close and apply. And if you look at this here, the values are going to change. So Bill is 75, the first one. Now it has changed to Adam, it is 54. Because if you look at sorted by alphabetic order, the first country, the first name which comes here is Adam, and the first value is the 54 of it. So that's the here. So this is how it actually works, the first non-blank and first non-blank value, to make sure that it is sorted by alphabetic order. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notification. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.